Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am back again today, ready to show you how I made this awesome sunflower mandala shirt. Now, sunflowers are totally in right now, so this is sure to be a big hit, not just with you, but with all of your customers as well. And to top it off, what we're gonna do is tell you all of our tips and tricks on what type of mandala file to look for and what type of vinyl that you wanna choose to make sure that this project is as painless as possible. Let's get started. So here we are on designbundles.net, of course. Now for this project, I already knew what type of file I wanted for my t-shirt. So I just came over to the search bar and I typed in a sunflower mandala. And this brought me to a whole bunch of options, and I was simply able to just scroll and see which one really spoke to me, which one matched the design I had in mind. Because, you know, let's be honest, Design Bundles has a lot of really good designs, sometimes it'll just take a minute to scroll through and find the one that you really want. In addition to that, while you're scrolling, it's very likely that you'll find more than one design that you like. For example, I really love this one here by Cheese and Toast Digitals because I'm really digging the awareness ribbons. So this is actually the one that I'm going to go with, though, because I want a mandala. And let me show you one thing that I look for. I'm not a huge fan of weeding, but I really like designs that make it look like I weed a lot. And on this one, if you'll notice, a lot of these pieces are connected to the outside. And what that means is that after I cut, whenever I go to weed this, a lot of these pieces will come away either really easily or they'll be connected together. Or if I'm really lucky, they'll all come out when I'm peeling back my entire design. So that is the one I'm going to go with. We can exit out of that preview screen and we'll go through the purchasing scenario. We'll add to cart and I can just click on my cart over here and hit checkout now. You'll see my Plus membership discount is here, but this is the file. Of course, if you've selected more than one file, you'll see multiples here. Click continue to payment. So you guys know I'm a really big fan of store credit. In this case, because I'm already using my Plus membership discount, I don't get to double dip, but something to keep in mind. So now here, all I have to do takes me straight to this preview page, download my product. It'll take me to my purchases, hit download files here. Scroll down just a tiny bit and click on my file to download the zip folder. Now remember that I cannot open files straight from a zipped folder, so I'm going to open this file up. It opens up right here in my downloads and I can hit extract all. It will extract it to my downloads, and what this means is that Windows just bam took care of that process for me. I can now go to my downloads folder. And here now is my unzipped files. You can see I have different files to choose from. The ones that I'm gonna be worried about are the SVG file here. And if you're using a basic edition of Silhouette Studio, then this DXS format is the one that, that you wanna focus on. Okay, but we'll talk more about that after a while. For now, I'm happy. I downloaded my file, I've extracted my file, and I'm ready to move into Silhouette Studio so that I can now cut this design on my die cutting machine. Once I'm in Silhouette Studio, I can now proceed to open the file that I have purchased and downloaded. So there are two ways to do this, but for our purposes today, we are going to use File and Open. Okay, now we need to locate the file in our Downloads folder. So I'm going to simply come over here. I have a download shortcut key, and here is my file that I downloaded. You can open it up. Now, remember, if you're using the basic format of Silhouette Studio, you will need to open and work with the DXF file. There's nothing wrong with that file. There's nothing really different about that file. It's just the format that you need to be able to use. We are going to proceed with the SVG file, which will just be filled in with color. It's one of the main differences that you'll notice, but you have to have the designer edition of Silhouette Studio or higher to be able to use SVG formats. Now, if you have the basic edition and you try to open an SVG file, it will just tell you that this file type is not supported. And that'll be your little friendly reminder to come back in and say, okay, self, don't try to open SVG. Let's shoot for the DXF file this time. All right. So SVG file, I just double clicked and it will open right here in my, see, it opened a new tab up here in my design area. Okay, now let's talk about what we're looking at here. I am using this for a full-size adult t-shirt. In particular, I'm using it for a t-shirt for myself. So I want to make sure that I am sizing this appropriately, and I want to make sure that the design area is set up the way it needs to be set up. So first and foremost, my vinyl that I'm using to cut this out, I'm going to now adjust my page size to match the size of the vinyl. So I will type in 12 inches wide by 15 inches long. Now you notice it automatically lets me know, hey, you're using a 12-inch mat, so you need to be aware of that. Make sure that you turn on this cut border, and it will tell you. Now, it will show you that you can cut all the way down here. Don't believe it. That is false. What it's actually wanting you to do is use a 12 by 24-inch mat. And if you have one of those, that's really great. If you don't have one of those, just keep in mind that you can only cut 11.5 by 11.5 to keep the design safely on your cutting mat and within your media. So that's okay, because for this design, I'm going to, over here on the right hand side, open my transform panel and use my scale option, which is the second icon. I want to lock my aspect ratio, which is right here, because I don't want to skew the way that my sunflower looks. And I'm simply going to type in 11 inches across. You see that enhanced, enlarged my entire design. And this is what I'm looking at, which is nowhere near. Let's take a look. If we were to only be using a 12 by 12 piece and cutting on a 12 by 12 mat, this design is still well within the parameters that we need. I am going to center the design to the cut area and make sure that I leave myself a little bit of a border along the top. Now, anytime that you're cutting heat transfer vinyl with Silhouette Studio or your Silhouette Cameo, you do need to mirror the design. And what I mean by that is you want to flip horizontally. What we're going to do now is we are going to come over to our send panel and select the cut settings that we need. Now, you may or may not notice that this did not light up in bright red colors. What that means is that your cut lines are not turned on and this file is not going to cut in your software. So what you need to do is make sure that you've clicked on it and click cut. There, doesn't that look a lot different? So that is one thing you'll have to remember with SVG files, but that's okay, because really you should be looking at this regardless of what type of file you're working with, just to make sure that it's going to cut in all the right areas and that you don't accidentally have any extra pieces hanging out in your design space. Now over here in material type, because I have selected a smooth heat transfer vinyl, I am going to scroll. Not all the way down. I went too far. Heat transfer smooth right here. Now, keep in mind, I cut with a ratchet blade, and that's okay because I'm old school and that's what I'm used to. So you want to check and make sure which blade you're cutting with. If you're using an auto blade, that's perfectly fine. Just come here and switch it to an auto blade. I'm going to switch it back because I am, in fact, using the ratchet blade. Down here at the bottom is where you will select your test cut. It is going to cut a small area up here in the very top of your mat, just to make sure that your cut settings are correct. If they are correct, then you can proceed with clicking the send button and sending this to cut on your Silhouette Cameo. Now at this point, you may be saying, Wait a minute, Becky. If I remember your shirt correctly, you cut your design from two different colors. Yes, that is absolutely correct, and we are going to show you how to take care of that as well. So let's click back over to the design menu, panel, area, and we are going to move this off to the side. And what we're going to do is we will right-click and ungroup our image, and that breaks it into two different areas. So the reason that I go and move this off to the side is because now I can bring on this file, go through the same process, just cut this file, and then when I'm ready, I can move that off to the side and move this color up here, and now come here and cut that in the next color that I choose. Okay, let's also talk about one more thing that you can do. If you're comfortable and familiar, some people get a little nervous about this because they feel like, there's a little bit more room for error, and technically there is. It is called the cut by color. So up here at the top, you have action by, and you, for my instance, I'm going to choose fill. And you'll notice it breaks out the two colors that I have. I can select neither, I can select one color, or I can select the other. Now, the important thing to notate here, number one, is that your design does not light up in bright red. That's okay. It's going to light up in a bold color that represents the fill color of that shape. Okay, makes it a little bit harder to see sometimes, but it is there. And then also, let's talk about the fact that in this design, I would be wasting all of this heat transfer vinyl up here unless I just wanted to cut in from the side and weed that out. So for this instance, I would not use the cut by color, but it is an option that's available to you as long as you have Designer Edition or higher. So just something to keep in mind if you don't want to play the back and forth game of moving everything on and off of the mat. It's just not always the most efficient way to cut. So here we are. I've already let the Cameo cut my design out, and we're ready to take a look at weeding and assembling this file to get ready to press on my t-shirt. So I have a couple tools here. Of course, I have a pair of scissors, just basic scissors, my fabulous weeding tweezers that I absolutely love, and in case you guys haven't seen this before, it's a weeding ring. So let me tell you about this thing real quick, just because it's such a help with these small pieces of vinyl. I'm going to put this on my hand, and then, well, maybe I'm more comfortable here. Wherever's comfortable for you. And then as I'm picking these pieces, I put them in the weeding ring, so they come right off the end of my tweezers. Okay, so just showing you what I'm doing and what I'm working with. So let's go ahead and trim these. Now you can hold them to the light and usually see your cut lines. Just be careful. You do not want to cut too close. You can set those aside for later. Now this one is pretty big. I'm not going to have a lot to save, but this is such a pretty color. And let's go ahead and talk about why I chose the vinyl that I did. First of all, I mean, it's a gorgeous color. Look at that color. Second of all, I really needed to make sure I chose a vinyl that would handle the detail well. Okay, because not all vinyl is created equal, and I did not want to choose a vinyl that was going to, not give me good cut lines. And I mean, there's some vinyl, like, okay, for example, glitter vinyl. Okay, love me some glitter vinyl. But at the same time, it doesn't always handle detail very well, right? But this is smooth vinyl. It handles the detail well. And for the most part, it will cut anything that I've asked it to cut. Now, I can go ahead and tell you that this one in particular, if you can see, it does look like I either have lost or I might lose some smaller pieces. That's okay. You don't really have to stress too hard because mandalas look great no matter what your cut results are. All right, so I am going to weed this one first. I always start with the outside. I just pierce and then pull it towards me. and my design will easily start coming apart as long as I've done my test cut and got those good cut settings. And as I pull, there we go. So it looks like that part tried to come up a little bit. We'll just put those back down. And literally that is all I have to do. So I have this awesome mandala, and just like I was talking about when we were choosing the design, it literally came apart in one pull. There's nothing else that I need to do with that. Now, this one will not be as simple, only because I already know that there are some smaller pieces on the inside that I'm gonna have to weed. But with our tweezers and our weeding ring, it's not gonna be a big complicated mess. So pick any side, I pierce it with my weeding tweezers, and set those down. And with this one, I'm gonna go ahead and work my way around. But if you notice, a lot of my inside pieces are already coming up. Now you'll notice some of them break away, like this one broke right here. That's okay, because we're gonna come back and weed that part with our tweezers. But if you remember, the reason I chose this design is because a lot of these pieces are coming up and it's not going to require a whole lot of work on my part. And you know, I'll say this, I know that some people just absolutely love weeding, especially heat transfer vinyl, but that person is just not me. So if that is you, that's okay. I'm not judging you for it by continually talking about choosing files that are easy to weed. But you know, especially when we're talking about a quick project, I'm a pretty instant gratification kind of person, and I like to be able to buy my file, get it cut, get it weeded, and start wearing the shirt as soon as possible. Do you see how much came apart on just our very first pull? So I'm gonna go back in with my tweezers and get the rest of it. I believe that I am done. So check that out, that gorgeous, gorgeous color. And it's gonna match really good with my gold in the middle. Ta-da! Okay, so this is the shirt I chose. It's a nice charcoal gray. It's a really soft material. And I really, when I picked it out, I love how much the colors really pop against the gray. So something to keep in mind when you're keeping out colors, you want to really look for that contrast color. So the first thing I'm going to do, here we will turn this long ways. And I want to fold my shirt in half, as long as it's actually in half. This doesn't work if you're terrible at folding shirts. I will rate myself as a mediocre shirt folder. Okay, let's try that. Is that better? Just a little bit better. Okay, but basically what I want to do, I'm going to serve two purposes here once I get all these wrinkles out. Okay, I'm going to pre-press my shirt at the same time that I'm going to press a guideline in there. Okay, and the purpose of the guideline, what I'm doing is I'm lining up my fold on the side. The purpose of the guideline is to help me center the design on my shirt. So I'm going to grab my easy press. This is set up for 320 degrees for 15 seconds. just want to give it some pressure. I want to make sure that I really press those lines in there. Now, ideally, I would be using the Cricut Easy Press on a low surface so that I could get a lot of leverage for pressing my design on there. Now I can unfold my shirt, and it is pre-pressed, and let's see if you guys can see it. I have one guideline here and one guideline here. Now, that does not mean that I want to take my design and put it right here, because that would be the middle of my stomach and that would be awkward for everybody. What I want to do as my guide, I know that for myself and for most people, the bottom seam of the armpits right here of the shirt, of the underarms, okay, that's going to be mid-chest for me. But I still need this guideline here because it'll help me keep it straight. Luckily for me, mandalas are not an exact science. I don't have to get them exact, but just as a crafter, I feel like, you know, anything worth doing, right? All right, so there we go. Now you'll notice I have both of my designs lined up here. I cannot press this like that, all right? I need to peel my gold off, and we will press that one next. Okay, now I do need to cover with my Teflon. I'm gonna grab my Easy Press again. So we are going to Easy Press this in two steps because my Easy Press is only 12 by 10 and my design is 11 by 11. Okay, but I'm also not pressing the full amount right off the bat, and that's because we're going to be layering. And I don't want to overcook my vinyl. Now for a two-layer design, I don't believe that overcooking is a real big issue, but if we were doing multiple layers, you know, where I'd be pressing over and over and over, then that definitely would be an issue. There we go. Now I can line up my gold. Just make it all pretty in there. There we go. Cover with my Teflon again. Now at this point, we will go ahead and press for the full 15 seconds that this heat transfer vinyl requires. Now the time and temperature of your heat press will be determined by the manufacturer of the HTV. So while I'm using 320 for 15 seconds, you also want to just double check with your manufacturer or the place that you purchase from and see what they recommend as the heat press settings. And if you're doing this with an iron, that is a-okay. There's actually a tool that you can purchase. It is like a laser thermometer. I think I picked one up at the hardware store, and basically you use that laser to determine the temperature of your iron. All right, heat pressing done. Let's see what we got. Ta-da! There is my gorgeous new sunflower mandala shirt. Now, I do want to say, sometimes when you're layering, okay, I did not have it here because I'm using my Easy Press, but if I were to layer this on here and press with a lot of pressure, it's possible that I would get a line around the outside. What I would do then, if that happened to you, it doesn't take it away, but it helps if you lay this back on top and press it, and it kind of, I don't want to say it absorbs those pressing lines, but it does help to smooth them out. All right. So what do you guys think? I think it looks absolutely fabulous.
Well guys, thank you for joining us here on Design Bundles. I hope you learned a few things about layering HTV and cutting and weeding mandalas, what to look for, and we certainly hope that you'll join us here again in the future. Thank you.